heading on a 9,500-kilometer trip to live with a true Galway girl, Grainne Seoige. Agus Toshi Kahali. Grainne began her broadcasting career in 1996 with the launch of Tina G. She also became the launch anchor with TV3. Bill Clinton is facing the biggest crisis of his presidency tonight. A bunch of shiny TV shows later meant she was rarely off our screens. But the sparkle in her eye now comes from working with Diamonds in South Africa. After a move from Ireland in 2014, she now lives here with her fiancé, Liam.
So this is very, very exciting. Now I'm clearly jet-lagged because I am in Joburg in South Africa. And I'm about to move in with someone who I honestly thought in a million years would never let me in. It is Grainne Seoige at her diamond factory. I cannot wait to see her and fleece her. I'm going to take loads of diamonds back to Ireland.
Grainne lives in the outskirts of Joburg, so we've arranged to meet up in the city and drive there together.
How surreal is this?
You brought the weather.
The state of it. I'm dying to see away. My eyes are actually so dry. Like, I've no liquid in my body. Let's rehydrate.
Yes, let's do that.
Oh my God, I can't believe, like you said, that it was kind of warmish during the day. I'm going to actually genuinely put on my bikini.
Well, you do that.
I'm going to stay in the jeans. Well, let me get my handbag.
My bag.
This is so exciting. I just feel like a bit of a sweaty Betty.
Me too.
Like, will there be an opportunity for me to put on a bikini?
Yeah, bikini in the bush.
That sounds worse than I meant it.
That's the name of my new book.
So tell me, why did you finally succumb to letting me into your life? Because you watched it private.
Yeah, it's a very good question. I think because I'm here, it's a little bit different.
Yes.
Do you know what I mean? You do a show like this.
Because it's real.
Yeah, because it's real. And that's what people now expect for you, which is your...
USP.
Your USP is you talk about we all the time.
Yeah. Love it. It's my chosen subject. Everybody uses the loo.
Exactly.
Most people look shocking first thing.
People don't use the loo quite as much as you do, I think.
No,
I think you need to get that checked out.
Yeah, no, definitely. Or I'm gonna come up with a good pitch to do a show from the loo. I love it, yeah. Well, I have no pelvic floor. This is the problem, having three babies. It's got.
How are
you with sneezing or trampoline?
Forget it.
I've been on a trampoline in 6 years.
Yeah, don't.
So do you love it here? Like, does this now feel like home?
Yeah. When I talk about going home,
this is it here.
Yeah, but that's so nice. My man is here, my dogs are here, my bed is here. I think that's your home, isn't it?
Yes, and you spend most of your time here.
And I spend most of my time here.
Is it nice to have your anonymity?
It's lovely. It's really lovely. Now you walk in and you speak, and straight away people know, oh, you're from another place. And actually, they love the Irish accent out here.
Yes.
So people are genuinely intrigued.
Yeah, intrigued.
Why are you here? And then when you say your other half is South African, they're like, ooh.
Like, you definitely love him, because when you think about it, it was a big move.
You
didn't move to London.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Exactly. No, it's the other side of the world and culturally very, very different.
Yeah.
But you know what? It was a no-brainer, actually.
Wow.
I love this man. I want to be with him. What's it going to take this? Thank you. Let's do it.
Wow.
But that's...
So how long were you together then commuting?
We were only together a year and a half when he emigrated again.
Oh, my God.
So that's quite soon, actually. But we knew how we felt about each other very early doors. And I think that's the other thing. When you meet somebody that's slightly bit later...